Halloween is right around the corner. We went out to sample gates to hear what Hoosiers are dressing up as this year.
IU's favorite small town boy has been immortalized on campus. Stay tuned to find out how and where.
And Carson and I tried the new wellness studio at the SRSC. Hear about the benefits and how you can use it too.
It's corn maze season. Find out about the pumpkin patch in Bloomington with a maze that features a familiar face this year.
Plus, ESPN is headed to B-Town. We talk about who's coming and how you can watch.
Hello and welcome to What's Up Weekly. I'm Carson Johnson.
And I'm Grace Marocco.
Grace, we are finally getting the Saturday afternoon college football treatment. How does it feel? Are you excited?
Amazing. I never thought this day would come, honestly.
I am so excited. And I can't wait to be breathing the same air as Nick Saban.
Oh, do you like him that much?
I do. I think he's awesome.
I mean, he's okay, but... Anyways, a clinic at IU Bloomington is offering more than just healthcare. It's making a real difference for LGBTQ plus students. WU reporter Mike Badrov has the story. Mike?
Thanks, Grace. Healthcare can be a scary thing, but this weekend I had the pleasure of talking with multiple medical professionals behind a new primary care clinic for the Bloomington area.
The clinic opened its doors for the first time to the public on October 20th. And here's Marissa Vandermissen, the fourth-year medical student chair, on the story of the clinic's creation.
This project has been ongoing for nearly 5 years, and I was lucky to inherit this idea that was started by some student chairs before me. They came up with this idea after doing a research study looking at the health needs of the LGBTQ plus community in South Central Indiana. And what they found with their research was that there is a huge need for LGBTQ plus competent primary health care providers, as well as providers who are willing to provide gender affirming health care, including gender affirming hormone treatment.
While created with the LGBTQ plus community in focus, the clinic is open for everyone in need.
Our clinic is open to everyone. You do not have to identify as LGBTQ to receive care. We are a primary care clinic offering gender-affirming primary care to underinsured and uninsured members of the community.
The students that drove this project were excited with the result of their first day.
I think I was a little too excited to be the first patient. I almost wanted to go up to them and be like, thank you for showing
up. Hug them, be like, hi!
Dr. Cassandra Dishman-Kessler, a doctor for the clinic, is pleased with the results of the first day and would love to expand to be able to treat more patients.
Right now, we're planning to host one clinic a month, one Sunday, like half day, 4-hour clinic. And longer term, we want to be able to have, ideally, you know, a full schedule of patients that we're taking care of on a regular basis.
I cannot stress how amazing these students and doctors are. The Bloomington community is lucky to have these wonderful professionals that are passionate about taking care of others. That's all from me. Now back to you.
Thanks, Mike. Dancers from around the Midwest joined the IU Ballroom Dancing Club for their first home competition in 5 years. The Cream and Crimson Dance Competition hosted dancers from Ohio State, the University of Michigan, and Purdue. The competition was held at Alumni Hall in the IMU. IU, of course, took center stage, earning a total of 19 first place ribbons, securing a big win for the home team. The dancers say they're hoping to make the competition an annual event.
We hope to hold it next year and get a decent number of people back and hopefully more people in general, since we know better how to plan this thing now.
We're hoping that this comp goes well enough that more people will want to come because they heard how great it was.
The group says they have their sights set on an even bigger turnout for next year.
Indiana Hoosier legend John Mellencamp was honored with a statue on IU's campus over homecoming weekend. The ceremony took place on Friday at the North Garden of the IU Auditorium. Hundreds of fans were in attendance to watch Mellencamp speak and sing his biggest hits. University dignitaries attended the event, as did Mellencamp's closest friends and family. Mellencamp performed fan favorites Small Town and Jack and Diane as his band joined him on stage for the memorable moment. Before unveiling the bronze statue, President Pamela Whitten recognized Mellencamp's numerous contributions to the university. For decades, Mellencamp has donated money for scholarships and other charitable causes on behalf of the university. He most recently donated his archives of music and artwork to Indiana University.
This statue will stand as a reminder of his contributions and as an inspiration to future generations of Hoosiers. So thank you, John, for your music, and thank you for your passion and commitment to Indiana and to the university.
The John Mellencamp statue is the eighth statue on Indiana University's campus as he joins an exclusive list of Hoosiers who have made the greatest impacts for the university.
Who else do you think they need statues of on campus?
I feel Laverne Cox could be up there, maybe. Mm-hmm. Who was I recently thought of somebody, but I don't even remember who it is. But who do you feel?
Okay, might be controversial. I don't even think John Mellencamp graduated from IU, did he?
I was thinking that earlier.
So, like, why? Yeah. Sorry. Okay, Jack and Diane, pretty good, but statue? Still to come up on What's Up Weekly, we're bringing you the latest on this week's trending topic, starting with some heartbreaking news from the music world.
And get ready, because a popular show is touching down at IU. All that and more coming up next.
Welcome back to Trending Topics. Well, starting off with some really sad news today. New details of the death of a former One Direction member, Liam Payne. An autopsy report released Friday confirms that Payne died after falling from his third floor hotel balcony. The report says the 31-year-old suffered multiple traumatic injuries, such as internal and external bleeding, resulting in his death. Police say they responded to the 911 call from the hotel just minutes before Payne was found dead. The 911 call was reportedly from a hotel manager complaining about a man who was acting recklessly and probably intoxicated. The toxicology report confirms that there was a list of drugs in Payne's system when he died. This story is just so sad, Carson. When I first heard the news, I thought someone was pranking me.
Well, I first heard the news actually from our IUSTV group chat.
Yes, and yes, me too.
Yeah, were you a big One Direction fan?
Yes, I was.
Yeah,
so sad, and he was so young.
I know, I was never a super big fan, but regardless of whether or not I listened to their music, I was shocked that like one of the brightest stars of our childhood went out a bit too soon, I feel.
It is really sad.
Yeah, completely. Well, little bit of shift of tone, but the much-anticipated movie adaptation of the Broadway musical Wicked comes out in just a few weeks. Cynthia Erivo, who stars in the film as Elphaba, recently took to Instagram to speak her mind about some fans altering the movie poster to resemble the Broadway poster and making lurid jokes about her. She said, "None of it's funny and none of it's cute." Well, I don't think the fan really meant to offend, but I totally see why it would come off the way it did to Cynthia, especially considering she's put so much time and effort into the movie. But the movie is meant to be to pay homage to the film, not be a replica of the musical. Well, everyone's a critic, I guess. Mm-hmm. I can see both sides of the argument. I do think that Cynthia might have been doing a little bit too much.
I think so, too. And I've seen a lot of people comment on it publicly on social media saying they don't even want to see the movie anymore because she had such a bad attitude when it came to the poster.
I know. I don't know.
It's people are haters gonna hate, but I don't know. I think she might have went a little overboard on that.
Yeah, well, haters are gonna hate, and haters are gonna hate on IU too, but let's hear some more.
But just because they hate doesn't mean it's true. ESPN's College Game Day is coming to Bloomington for the first time. The announcement was made on Instagram last Sunday. Of course, it's for tomorrow's game against Washington, the first time Indiana and Washington have played against each other in 21 years. The show's lineup includes some pretty notable figures like Pat McAfee, Nick Saban, and former Indiana head coach Lee Corso. The pit opens at 6:30 in the morning in the South Lawn of Memorial Stadium, but fans can line up even earlier. I'm so excited, Carson.
I know, I can't wait. I might get to, I might try to get up in the background of College Game Day. I just can't wait.
I would love to and make a little sign, cheer. I've heard some people are getting there as early as 1 in the morning.
That's a little bit crazy. Well, you heard it here, Indiana's a football school. And when we come back, we've got a fitness segment that looks a little bit different.
Yeah, that's right. We aren't working out, but instead relaxing. You'll say what we mean when we come back. Welcome back. Earlier this week, Carson and I went to the SRSC to experience the new wellness studio.
That's right. As we know, the SRSC went through several renovations over the summer, one of them being the new wellness studio. We tried it out ourselves. Please take a look.
Of course, Carson and I had to check out the SRSC's newest wellness studio. Brady Bowden, one of the assistant directors, filled us in on the three new machines.
First one you see when you walk in is actually the relaxed space. So the relaxed space is kind of more about meditation and just kind of relaxing. So there's a really big screen on it. You put some headphones on, listen to some like really nice sounds, and just kind of like zone out everything else.
Right now I'm outside of the relaxed space. All you do is open up this door, take a seat inside, and we're just gonna scan my Crimson card. So once I scan my card, I just hit start here, and there are so many options that you can use in this relaxed space. There's different things you can do with heat or even scent. There's spring water, fresh pine, lemon leaf, tropical. This is just one of the machines that are in the wellness studio. There's so many things for students to use.
The second one is a hydro massage, which is like you're similar to like a hands-on massage, except it uses water. And it covers the whole body, really good for like sore muscles, recovery, things like that. And then the last one is actually the cryo lounge, which is like a hot and cold kind of device, which is really cool. So you can set different spots on like if you want heat therapy, maybe if you have like low back that's been really sore or something, you can do that. Or you can put cold wherever you want to. So again, it's really about workout recovery. And just kind of taking care of yourself.
Access to the wellness studio is completely free with a Crimson card. For more information, check out their website at recsports.indiana.edu.
You may have noticed the trees changing colors right here in Bloomington. The fall colors are at their peak across much of the state this week, according to the Smoky Mountains fall foliage map. So how long will this last? Well, by October 30th, the northern portion of Indiana is expected to be past peak. But in southern Indiana, we should be seeing those colors for a little bit longer.
And with Halloween right around the corner, we want to know what you are being.
Our WU correspondents Charlie Herman and Dana Bellmer went around IU's campus to find out what students have planned for this year's Halloween. Take a look.
Hi Hoosiers, I'm Charlie.
And I'm Dana.
We're out here at Sample Gates asking fellow Hoosiers what they are being for Halloween this year.
Charlie, let's see what's trending.
Let's do it.
I'm going to be the Devil Wears Prada.
I'm going to be a Victoria's Secret angel.
I'm being Cousin Eddie from National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. One of my friends was it a few years ago, and I'm actually just copying him. So
I'm going to be Coach Sig, the best coach in college football.
Thinking a cowboy.
Patrick Starr.
Batman.
My roommates and I are doing Alvin the Chipmunks, and I will be doing Theodore.
Maddie from 13 going on 30.
Amanda, what are you being for Halloween this year?
I'm being Handy Manny.
An inflatable clown.
I'm thinking about being a fat inflatable clown. I'm thinking about being a skinny inflatable clown.
I'm going to be Kesha for Halloween.
I'm being Rob from Love Island. This way I get to be funny, relevant, and warm.
I'm being Wolverine. I was named after Wolverine. His name is also Logan.
Right.
My grandma was watching X2 and my mom called to ask for baby name suggestions. So I figure this is like my time to shine.
Well, speaking of Halloween, it is right around the corner, and IU police are sharing tips to keep in mind to stay safe over what is typically a busy party weekend. When it comes to your costumes, you're not encouraged to wear something that covers your face or blocks your ability to see the environment around you. Also, be careful with costumes with fake weapons that may cause unintended panic to others and police. The biggest thing to remember, police say, is understanding Indiana's Lifeline Law, which protects minors from alcohol charges when calling police for a medical emergency. If you see anything suspicious, don't hesitate to call 911. Well, speaking of Halloween and fall, the Fowler Pumpkin Patch is a loved Bloomington tradition, but this year things are looking a little bit different.
Yes, they are. The Pumpkin Patch has a Bob Knight themed corn maze. Sydney Moore has more.
I'm here at Fowler's Pumpkin Patch, where the theme for this year's corn maze is famous basketball coach Bob Knight.
A lot of us that grew up back in the 70s, he was a hero to us. We all wanted to play ball for Bobby, and I feel like he gave back a lot to this community. So we are tributing him this year by doing this corn maze, and we're teaming up with Alzheimer's to do a little tribute to him. We're going to donate some money to Alzheimer's care.
Precision Mazes from Missouri gets a photo for inspiration and uses a GPS system to make the maze each year.
It's just a picture of Coach Knight and he's pointing, which is pretty cool. I can actually see him doing exactly what the corn maze is.
This is their most difficult maze yet, but if you follow the map, you should be able to get out in 15 to 30 minutes.
I've heard plenty of people talk about the big one and say that it takes quite a while and it's pretty difficult.
Fowler says even though Knight had a controversial reputation, those who come say they love the tribute.
I think it's a really big part of like our town, and like Bob Knight is a really known person around here, so I feel like it's really memorable to have that as part of our corn maze this year.
Fowler tells me he's hoping to raise a couple thousand dollars this season to donate to the Alzheimer and Dementia Resource Service. In Bloomington, I'm Sydney Moore, IUSTV News.
I want to know how you even, like, how do you do that? Get a whole thing into a, like, turn it into a maze?
That's what I'm wondering, too, because honestly, I was a little scared at the beginning when they said it was going to look like Bob Knight. I was like, no way, that's going to look like a blob. But when they showed it, that actually is amazing.
They have his face and they have different fonts
in writing. And his signature, yeah. It looks just like that. And the cause is amazing.
So impressive.
And that's what's up this week. Tune in next week for more local and entertainment news.
Be sure to follow us on social media. Follow us on Instagram at IUSTVWoo.
For What's Up Weekly, I'm Grace Morocco.
And I'm Carson Johnson. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.